Gli applausi sono per un grandissimo Simon Yates. Simon Yates.
Trying to follow the plan of the day on Whitey's whiteboard, theme of the day. What's on the whiteboard today, Mr. White?
I was never any good at art at school. So keep the drawings to a minimum.
Here I was thinking it was Hangman.
It's time to tear this place down. I've got the last game on my mind. Not seen my friends in ages. How about you let me?
All right, welcome to Backstage Pass, Stage 6. The first crucial showdown between the GC guys. Really long climb today. We've come hit Etna from a very different side, and it really does kick up 5.5 kilometres to go. I think today's not going to be too big a gap between the key guys. The only guys who maybe get caught out are the guys who aren't really on top of their game, and they could be in a little bit of trouble. But I expect to see not too big a gap between the key guys today.
It's going to be a gnarly day, actually. Not that the last 5 days have been anything other than gnarly. First big test for the GC guys. Everyone's talking about Etna. I'm worried about every other part of the stage. Pretty hard.
So someone's asked me through Instagram who gets the worst sunburn, and to be honest, we're doing pretty good. None of us have sunburn yet because we have beautiful Pre-Max sunscreen to keep us safe in the sunshine. New person to harass with some questions, we're going to harass Sueno.
You love that.
So shoot the questions through and we'll try get him to answer some.
Pour in the obvious Mount Etna question. Darcy Port 1 would like to know, if you do get on the podium, will you do a shoey?
A shoey? What's a shoey?
Shoey is when you pour your beer into your shoe, i.e. your Scott lace up, and just sneak it.
I'm not a big drinker. Well, especially not beer anyway.
Well, you can chew it in orange juice or something.
Yeah.
I'm doing it wrong now. If you're not a big drinker and you beat me every day.
All right, guys. All the best, though.
It's a panic stretch.
Stage 6 of the Giro d'Italia, and they go and put in a mountain like Etna.
Esteban Chavez up the front, and they're stopping behind. Chavez
pushing on.
Chavez off in pursuit, in hours behind, trying to fight for the bike left to left. But it is Esteban Chavez now hits the front of the Giro d'Italia.
The Colombian Esteban Chavez has taken this race. 21 seconds, it's a slender lead with still 2.3 kilometres to go. It certainly isn't over. He counters. Whoa, Yates counters the move now. He's opened up a bit of a lead, but in doing so, he's going to shut the gap. Big acceleration by Yates.
And if Chavez could win the stage, Yates to take time. We're looking at a perfect day for the Australian team.
The Giro d'Italia has really come to life here in Sicily.
Esteban Chavez behind him, who's worked so hard for him in the breakaway all day. It's going to be a 1-2.
No, boys, all the way to the line.
He's going to let Chavez come past. It is Chavez to win the stage. Yates in second. What a 1-2.
It's a big thing, you know. In the last kilometer, I just think of my friend. For sure, she pushed me from today. Yeah, it's also for the team. I don't know about the GC yet, but for sure it's good. And I needed this as well. I wanted to say thanks to the guys, JT as well. Jack was unbelievable today, and everyone, you know. Thank you very much. Now I just need to join.
So you're in the jersey.
Lou's in. I got the jersey, yeah. Oh.
Yay! Unbelievable. Like, what more can you ask for? First and second on the stage, leaders jersey. We wanted to win today, but we did it in a different way than we had planned. Oh, man, it's a long way to go to Rome, but things are looking good.
Very good day indeed. Probably the biggest win this team's ever had. Incredible show of force there by the boys, and very, very classy act by Yatesy as well. So Esteban, a super ride there. It certainly wasn't planned. I didn't expect, and we didn't expect such a big group to go away. But the boys played it very well, having Jack and Esteban in the break there. And that gave our other guys the ability to sit on and only to react in the final of the climb, which Simon certainly did. And it's a very, very pleasing day for the whole organisation.
How was that?
Peter Whitey, there's a little concern that you're eating your Pringles upside down.
I'll have to go back to the video, referee. I didn't know there was a correct way to eat Pringles, whether that's curve up or curve down. I'll have to go back and look at that one, mate.
Would curve up or curve down be your preference, do you think?
Well, I would think curve down, then you would be able to fit your tongue in the arc there to absorb the most flavour. Guessing there.
We're just seeing if it's the right size. It's an X, an XS. I reckon it looks pretty nice, actually.
Mackie got for €5.
Tutto cinque euro.
Mackie, you want the good news or the bad news? I don't reckon it's going to fit you.